Hello dear student, good afternoon. So today we learn the new topic. It's a vegetable crop, the brinjal. So let's see in detail the integrated pest management of brinjal. So first of all, the brinjal is one of the important Solanaceous vegetables and which is cultivated in all over the country that extensively grown, and due to its tender and some supple nature point of view, its cultivation under high moisture and input regimes, and the brinjal is more prone to pest attack. At a near about it estimate, the data whatever I obtained or collected, so is near about 35 to 40% losses. So why? Because the some problems about pesticides. So overuse of synthetic pesticide, so increase the cost of production, and to mitigate the losses due to the pest because of the huge quantity of pesticide in use in brinjal. Even some that it is like environmental and health hazards point of view at a consumer level, and so that's why here I have given or I am teaching you that some of the integrated pest management, some strategy that which will be helpful and highly used to the growers and to manage this all pest. So the which are this pest that related to this brinjal? So is a hada beetle, aphids, shoot and fruit borer, root knot nematodes, even some sucking pest. It's a red spider mite, mealybugs, that white fly. Among these all, this shoot and fruit borer is a very important major pest of brinjal. So let's see in detail the IPM strategy of this crop. So this first of all, we have to manage this pest from the point of view nursery. So first of all, to always prepare the raised nursery beds about 10 centimeter above, so that the ground level. Why? Because to good drainage point of view, and to firstly to avoid the damping of disease or whatever the different some soil borne or some other diseases. Even to cover the nursery beds with polythene sheet of 45 gauge micron, like 0.45 mm thickness of this polythene, and for 3 weeks, and during the month of June, and to use the soil solarization which help to the reducing the what may be the pest that hidden inside the soil, or diseases like bacterial wilt or like other organism, it's a nematode, so it destroy by this solarization. And however, care should be taken that we have to sufficient moisture is present in the soil due to solar during solarization. So these are the some nursery point of view that strategy we have to implement. So now this some mix 250 gram of the fungal antagonistic one, like called as these bioagents, like a Trichoderma viridi, at a rate of 3 kilogram, mix with the FIM and leave about that 7 days for enrichment of culture. After the 7 days, mix in the soil in bed of 3 square meter area, and whatever the second one practice, the some different popular hybrids variety like F1, like a 321, be sown in the beds in the first week of July, and before the sowing, the care should be taken the seed always treated with the Trichoderma viridi at a rate of 4 gram per kg. So whatever the cultivation practices that to use, like weeding practices, that time to time, and infected seedlings should be rolled out or removed out from the nursery. Why? To avoid the furthermore infestation. So now in the main crop, which are the some practices we have to view, the first of all, the after the transplanting, the bird perches, T-shaped bird perches, we can call them to sitting the birds. Like here I am showing you one picture, the birds that catching the larva here. So what? So this bird purchase is highly helpful to whatever the some birds that attracted to that this T-shaped stick or T-shaped bird purchase. So this facilitated to field visit and to act as a predatory nature and to destroy many larva, some other insect, even some like yellow sticky traps or delta traps at the rate of 2 to 3 acres that should be installed properly for the hopper sucking pest, aphids, some white fly sucking pest that to attract towards that yellow sticky trap, and we easily that to control like that. Okay, so give 2 to 3 spray of neem seed kernel extract at the rate of 5% against sucking pest and to avoid furthermore pest infestation. Even here the sprays of NSK also bring down the some borer incidence also. Okay, so neem oil also application also helpful to reducing borer infestation, though the marginally. So now the other, the suppose in case some sucking pest incidence is arise, so we that is near about the ETL level, so then apply the some insecticide that imidacloprid at the rate of 150 ml per hectare. Some pheromone traps also that very useful at the rate of 5 per acre should be installed properly in the field, and whatever the pest we have to check up point of view or to use the some control measure in furthermore. So that time the monitoring is important. That time this pheromone trap is very helpful. So that for the mass trapping, here the OTA trap, this is one the some like pheromone trap where that to install with the lure, that means the attractant. And here we can see in this OTA trap, all adults are captured or attracted towards. Even also this polythene sheet pheromone traps also that control the important pest, this Lucinodus arbonalis. So that previously I said you that shoot and fruit borer is a major pest in your brinjal. So for that purpose, this pheromone trap is very helpful. Suppose in case after the 15 to 20 days interval, so we have to change or replace the lure, this attractant, and that install this fresh lure after every 15 to 20 days interval. Even also the other like a parasitoid that known as Trichogramma brasiliensis at the rate of 1 lakh to 1 lakh 5 lakh per hectare against shoot and fruit borer. Near about 4 to 5 times at weekly interval, if we that release this Trichogramma, so we check the population during egg stage of this Lucinodus. Now, next one, apply neem cake at the rate 250 to kg per hectare in 2 splits in soil. So that at the rows that 25 and after the 60 days after transplanting to reduce the nematodes and other damage purpose, this neem cake is highly useful to control that. This is one of the next practices to clipping of the borer damage shoots, that to remove suppose the infested shoots are damaged. Suppose this are like the plant. Okay, so here this pest infestation that arise, so we have to remove this plant like a terminal shoot. Okay, so this is I am showing you one diagram. So this shoot we have to remove it properly. But so if this vegetative stage, this clipping practice if the farmers done, so whatever the some damage fruits in future will occur, so that time so destroy by this clipping. So this one, this important practices in this IPM. If the borer incidence crosses ETL that near about 5% infestation more, so apply the chemical pesticide cypermethrin at the rate of 200 gram per active ingredient per hectare, like our carbaryl that 3 gram per liter. So this is the other like a chemical spray that to control this pest. Now the next one, continuous cropping of brinjal leads to more borer, shoot borer and wilt infestation. To avoid that monocropping to year by year, that continuous cropping system of brinjal, like we have to alternate sowing, alternate that to crop rotation to give, so that the non-solanaceous crop should be followed, so that because of this shoot and fruit borer is a monophagous, it's require only the solanaceous crop. So if you that day by year by year that to same crop like a potato, like a brinjal, so there is a chances to like a shoot and fruit borer will attack. So periodically collect and destroy the egg masses, larva and adults of Hadda beetle point. Rogue out the little leaf affected plants from time to time to avoid some suckers. Plant is an insect. Use green manure, mulching practices with the polythene, soil application with bleaching powder will reduce the infestation of bacterial wilt also. So this is some practices regarding that brinjal. So which are the some like do's and don't, like these are the some like practices we have to that implement at the time of this IPM practices. So which are these that we have to do? So that timely sowing, field sanitation is must, always use freshly prepared neem seed kernels extract that to the furthermore infestation will easily that reduce. Apply insecticide only when required, that means the judicious pesticide, need based pesticide we have to required or to apply. So whatever what may be the pest incidences you that to obtain or that to observe, so that time to use the pesticide. Wash brinjal before consumption, that to maybe the chances to residue point of view. So which are the points that to remember to don't apply more than the recommended dose of pesticide, that to highly dose it, totally avoid it, don't repeat the same pesticide consequently. Why? Because they have the, suppose in case the mode of action is same, so we have to change the pesticide alternatively so that to reduce the chances to resistance and others that resurgence. Don't apply mixture pesticide. Okay, the don't apply highly hazardous insecticide like monocrotophos in vegetable, it's now not our not to apply because of there is a chance because the some other pollinators that will harm by this pesticide, even that some pesticide residue that to present in vegetable. So do not apply, don't apply pesticide just before the harvesting. Yes, this is very important practices. If we apply the pesticide, so in the future there is a chances to hazards to during consumption. Don't consume produce till 3 to 4 days after application of pesticide. So these are the some important points to remember during the that implementing or to follow the IPM practices. So dear students, so this is overall this IPM practices of vegetable of brinjal, very important crop this, and do assignment. Okay, thank you.